Many years ago, when I used to get anxious, I'm just checking that there's like nothing dodgy next to my bed. When I used to get anxious, the first thing I would do is whip out a camera and be like, "What's up, guys? It's Troy Sivan 18." So here I am, 2020. I'm a little bit anxious, I'm not gonna lie. Basically, there's a global pandemic, and I ran home to Australia like 6 months ago now, and it's time to go back. I was filming a movie in Atlanta when COVID-19 hit, and it really fucked up our shit. So we had to postpone shooting, basically. And I turned on the telly, and there was ScoMo, who's the Prime Minister here, and he was like, "Australians, come home." It felt kind of cool. It honestly felt like the Avengers, like, "Australians assemble," you know what I mean? And so I flew back thinking, oh yeah, like this is gonna be like a couple weeks, this will die down, and then we'll go back and shoot the movie. 6 months later, here I am. And it still feels premature to go back. And I am leaving, not tomorrow, but the next day, to go to Atlanta and LA and just like to kind of start my life again, basically. And I just feel really weird and like lonely and scared a little bit. I've spent every single waking moment with my family for the last 6 months. It's been really comforting to be in Australia, to be, you know, with my own medical system, and like there's very little COVID here. And fun fact about me, I did not sleep out successfully until I was, I think, 17. I used to get really, really gnarly homesickness when I was a kid. And the first time I ever successfully slept out was actually when I went to Sydney to go meet my record label for the first time. I just hated it. I'm like a homebody. I like my own bed. I like my family a lot. My siblings are some of my best friends, and I am a creature of comfort, okay? And then I've been fucking proud of myself because of the last like 5 years, 10, no, what am I talking about? 10 years. I have no concept of time. The last 8 years, I have been traveling a lot, and I feel really good, and I feel past my homesickness to a point. And I feel like that point might be global pandemic, can't come home whenever you want. If you do come home, you have to go into quarantine for 2 weeks. Big, bad, scary world out there. Like, I think that might be the point. I just feel really nervous. But I'm thinking maybe if I vlog the whole experience of me heading home, maybe it'll make me feel better. There is good news. The good news is I get to see my Bretty, I get to see my Ariana. My manager had a baby. I get to see meet the new baby. I get to go to work. I get to make a music video for In a Dream. I get to make the movie. And the most important thing, I haven't seen my dog in 7 months. And I'm gonna have my friend Gabby take him for a walk. And I'm gonna come home and I'm gonna hide and I'm gonna go. And hopefully, I would have set up this camera to film. And I'm gonna fucking surprise my dog. And it's like literally the single thing that gives me hope and makes me feel better about this whole situation. But yeah, thanks for being there for me. I appreciate it. Even though this is not alive, it makes me feel like there's people with me. So I really, really appreciate it.
Good morning. I'm pretty happy. Like, honestly, one of the biggest like things that I was nervous about was the night before I left. I always get really anxious at night, and so the fact that I managed to get a really good night's sleep last night and everything and like wasn't freaking out, that's a really good thing, I think. So I feel fine. I'm getting picked up to leave for the airport in an hour. Honestly, at this point, I'm just thinking about Nash. So feel good. Okay, I'm about to leave. I'm not gonna film myself saying goodbye to my brother and his girlfriend because that feels like too intimate, but just know it's a little bit rough right now. Yeah, we've spent like the last 6 months together, 24/7 basically. So this feels really, really weird. It feels like wrong to be traveling right now. You know what I mean? Like, I just don't feel like it makes a lot of sense. But you gotta do what you gotta do. And time to just like, you know, rise to the occasion. Character building. A lot of people have it a lot tougher. And I can do this. I got this. Yeah, cool. Thanks. All right, so I'm at the airport. It doesn't feel normal, put it that way. Okay, that was crazy. The guy who was sort of like checking me in, he calls the Australian government and he's like, just checking that this person, this Australian resident, has an exemption and like permission to leave. And the Australian government was like, yep. Then he has to call New Zealand because I'm transiting in New Zealand. And he's like, hey, just double checking that this person has the right to enter and like transit through New Zealand. They were like, yep. And then he has to call the US and he's like, oh, you're just checking that this guy can enter the US. And they were like, yep. But it was a crazy process. This is so creepy. Oh my God. I feel like I'm in a shopping center that's like closed. Walking to my gate. I feel like I have to whisper because, guys, am I in the wrong place? Like, what the fuck? Thank God there's these people behind me, these two people, because otherwise, like, I would feel so scared. This feels like a weird nightmare. Like, I feel like I've had this nightmare before.
Your attention, please. We can all help stop the spread of coronavirus by keeping our distance. This means not shaking hands or exchanging physical greetings, and, wherever possible, staying at least 1.5 meters away from others. Current Victorian government regulations require everyone over the age of 12 years, without exemption, to wear a face mask when in public. Together we can help stop the spread and stay healthy. Melbourne Airport thanks you for your attention.
I kind of die for the fact that the one girl, like that piano, right, is, it's open for passengers. It's not like a professional piano player. I love that the one passenger was like, this is cool and creepy, but you know what this moment needs? A creepy piano solo. Boarding. I'm just not thinking about it too much because if I think about it, I'm gonna get like anxious or emotional. But when this plane goes, there's no turning back. For now, all I have to do is get on this plane, which I can do. I don't know why vlogging makes me feel so much better, but I do feel a little bit nervous. A little bit like panicky, but just one step at a time. I'm gonna be okay. Yeah, all good. It's really sweet. The flight attendant just came up to me and like asked me how I was feeling. She was like, oh, you've got a long night ahead of you going to LA. How are you feeling? And I was like, oh, a little bit anxious. And she was like, oh, don't worry about it. Like, that's normal, I think. She's like, just take it one step at a time. I think that's all you can do. A little Kiwi guardian angel just like came up and spoke to me. So that's nice.
I just peed.
I watched Succession on the plane, like the first three episodes, and it's really good. Can recommend.
Well, I'm in Auckland, baby. I just washed my face and like freshened up. The airport is pretty full and there's like nowhere to sit, so I'm just gonna sit on the floor. I don't know how long my layer of race, I think I've got like 3 hours here. Super weird vibes, would not recommend.
So I was about to go get myself a little packet of chips or something from a vending machine, and then this kind man was like, oh, by the way, you can order food from like this place around the corner. So that sounds pretty cool. I'm really thankful for all these people that are being nice along the way. It makes everything much more pleasant. I guess you fill out this form. I'm gonna get the crispy Asian chicken salad. It's really good. I'm happy. All right, so they just said all of the people flying on this flight to LA come to do like additional screening or whatever. And there is 3 people on this flight, I think.
Oh wait,
4, because someone else had just arrived. But like 4 of us, that makes me want to like die. That makes me so anxious. But I guess it makes no difference. You know, once you're on the flight, you're on the flight. But that is creepy. That's never happened before. Never. An entire plane taking me and 2 other people? No. This is not right. This is not fucking right. I'm in actual shock. There's 5 of us total. It's like a private jet across from New Zealand to America. That is so far. I actually can't think about it. It's making me so scared. I'm gonna talk to the air hostess and like make friends with her. My fellow passengers. On the bus over here, I made some friends. I was like, guys, this is crazy. We spoke about why we're all traveling and like, I don't know, it was really nice. And I met some of you guys as well at the airport, which was really nice as well. Always makes me feel like I'm like safe, you know what I mean? All right, so we're coming in to land in LA. Flight was really good. I don't know. This is the weirdest thing in the world because like I'm technically landing home, but it's gonna be a very different LA from the last time I was here. So. We're not in COVID safe New Zealand anymore. Yeah, this is crazy. This is my first time being somewhere where like COVID is actually really thoroughly in the community. So it's a different kind of mindset.
This is like the lightest I've ever seen traffic.
Okay, I'm home. I can't believe it. I'm in my house. Holy shit. Okay, so Nash is out for his walk right now. I'm just like looking around because I feel like I've forgotten what my house looks like. It looks really nice. I'm so happy with this. And I'm gonna be hiding up here, chilling. Whoa, things look different in a good way. And I'm just gonna like fucking, I don't know, I'm probably gonna set up my laptop here to film. I feel really like, oh my God. Okay, so Nash cam is set up. That's gonna record. And then I think I'm just gonna like stand here and kneel down and greet my son. I'm kind of just like pacing around now because he's not home from his walk yet, but 10 minutes apparently. Also, I'm like, this is weird. I haven't seen any of these clothes in so long. I like don't know what I have, what I don't. Like all my pop star clothes are here. Like when would I have ever worn any of this in lockdown in Melbourne? You know what I mean? But it's cool to be like, oh shit, dang.